from New York. This is your Spurs night.
To start with my career, you know, the funny thing is, the very first thing is the Spurs, because without that, I would have done none of this. And so that was an internship that was given to me, thankfully, after I begged and begged and begged for something to do. And let me do a story for the Coyote Clubhouse one day. It was awful. I was awful. It wasn't awful. I sounded like an idiot and didn't know my own name, and it was just really bad. Thankfully, allowed me one more time to try. And that was the thing that got me started, I guess, in this whole thing. And after that, I ended up doing some bull riding, did some Travel Channel, did some Animal Planet, ultimately ended up in New York and was there for quite some time doing local stuff like the Yes Network up there. At the time, New Jersey Nets, that's how old I am. And yeah, and then eventually made it to ESPN, which was sort of my life for almost a decade off and on. I had already left ESPN at the time, so I took a good 2 years, 800 and something days, I think, between the last day I worked and the next day that I worked, and just sort of reevaluated what was important to me. I think through the whole journey, you learn a lot about yourself, about people, about the industry, what you want to do, what you don't want to do, and I did. And so I realized, A, didn't need to be in LA anymore, so I left. Came back to San Antonio, family, friends, and then it was just a no-brainer. I sort of reached out and they reached out to me. What would you like to do? What can I do? I'll do whatever you guys want. And so here we are. It's completely a full circle situation, which is awesome. Like, I don't think a lot of people get to do that, and I have enjoyed every second of it so far. I grew up out in, well, Fair Oaks technically. I mean, I became a Spurs fan when I was, I think, 12 or 13 years old. I went to a company event with my dad and got to meet David Robinson and Rod Strickland and was just like, this is awesome. So my connection has always been here.
We need to talk about that, because that's younger than my little brother. How is that, being in the NBA?
He was 18. I'd never done an interview. So he was my first interview. I think I was one of his first interviews when he got here. And then I got to see him again and got to interview him again. And I remember I had the picture of it. I was like, hell, look how young we were. That's a weird thing to think about, like my very first interview. It's a pretty good first interview, I won't lie. There is a lot to be learned from watching tape or watching yourself. You know, you don't realize some of the idiosyncrasies or tics that you might have. And the few times I've had to see it, it's like, it's not good. But it is kind of cool to go back and see the things that I've gotten to do. You know, whether it be like college football, where we did dumb shows on the road and whatnot. That part I like. But as far as like watching myself, no, I'd rather do anything else in the world. I think the ignorance is bliss thing was such a, it rang true for me, because a lot of my friends and people that I know in this world, they knew they wanted to do this from a young age. They went to school, you know, they went to the Syracuses and Northwesterns of the world to do this, and I just stumbled into this craziness. And so I have been able to kind of watch it through a different set of eyes. It's changed, a lot of it for better. I mean, there are a lot more women doing a lot more than just being sideline reporters. And I don't mean to say just as if to throw it away job-wise, but I do think there was a time when that was all we were allowed to do. And it's fine, and it's a living, but it's not always satisfying or fulfilling for a lot of people. And there are a lot of women out there that are great at hosting and analysis. I mean, we're seeing so many women now, like play-by-play and broad. To me, that is the biggest step forward, because A, I don't remember any women doing that when I first came around, and B, I like to think I can do almost anything on television, but the idea of doing play-by-play is terrifying, and so I will always envy and just admire the women that are doing that now, and they're good. Like the Doris Burks of the world, she's the OG, and I love her to death, all respect. There's this assumption, I think, that women in this world, like, you have to look a certain way or act a certain way or dress a certain way, and I never saw myself like that. We get sort of judged and stereotyped, and we have to work a lot harder. But I hate to say that, like, I don't mean to make it sound whiny. We have to work a lot harder in almost every industry, because it's been male dominated, and that has been the norm. And we are just judged on a different scale. If I mess up a name or a pronunciation, I'll get roasted. Same guy does it, nobody notices. And so hopefully that's changing a little bit more, but yeah, you kind of know going in. Try not to pay too much attention to it, or you'll get distracted. I don't like when people assume that when you talk about these things, that you're trying to preach. Like, no one's, I don't want to preach. I'm a feminist because I root for women. Being a feminist doesn't mean you root for all women. You root for the women that are good, the women that you love, the women that you admire, that you respect. And you also go into it thinking we are very much equals, and that's really all we're trying to say here. And it's silly that it's an argument that still has to be made. And so when I see organizations, and I do notice a lot more of that, a lot more women are being elevated, a lot more people of color are being elevated. There's an awareness that for sure did not exist 15, 20 years ago. So we are having an all women's broadcast on the 30th. It's gonna be awesome. I know that the women that I get to be with are different levels of where they are in their career. They're obviously young and hungry and, you know, the next great big star, who knows. But I also like the idea of just giving this opening, this audience, this moment to do something that's a little bit different, to feel comfortable and to sort of enter this platform that is, I mean, there's no reason why it should always just be male. And I look forward to it. I think this is gonna be, well, A, because I always am looking out for female talent and I want to always sort of be like, oh, that's the next great one. Not that I have any power to do anything about it, but it's also nice when people ask like, oh, I can tell you about some really great young women that are up and coming, and I think I'll enjoy it as much as they will, I hope. I think honestly, that's the simplest piece of advice, just be yourself. And I know that we grow up with a lot of people telling us that, but I think it just becomes words repeated over and over again. I genuinely mean to be yourself. It's palpable, like when people watch television, if you're authentic, if you are true to yourself, if you sound like a human being, it comes across that way. And if you're just someone sort of memorizing and robotic, which by the way, I did, and I was, and it was because I wasn't comfortable. And it wasn't until I was told by a cameraman here in San Antonio to be myself that I didn't get it. And it's the best piece of advice I've ever been given, and I continue to give it to others because it genuinely works if you take it to heart. There are gonna be assumptions, stereotypes, always. If you come prepared, if you know what your subject matter is, then there's no way they can embarrass you. And no one can say you were there for the wrong reasons when you're clearly, obviously, good at your job, ready for your job, always prepared. So that's the thing, and I know they always say that, just make sure you know your subject matter. But sometimes that's a little easier said than done. But it's the only way to be comfortable. And if you're comfortable, then that's the only way to be good on camera. And if you're good on camera, then all the dumb things that people want to say on the side, it doesn't matter. I think that this is a genuinely fun and interesting and great way to make a living. I am aware that it is very difficult and competitive and hard, but there are a lot of jobs, and sometimes they pit woman against woman as if there's just one job left in the world, and there's not. And I think we lose sight of that. And so my big thing was just try not to be a jerk. I mean, there's that saying about, you know, you're gonna see the people on the way up and you're gonna see the same people on the way down. And when you do it the right way, you won't be embarrassed to show your face. Because I have also met a lot of people who did it the wrong way. And there's, unfortunately, that's a lot of what happens. Don't do that. Just be yourself, surround yourself with good people, know what you're doing, and just understand also, it is a job. And like, I know we all sort of work too much, but it's a job, and it's a fun job, and it's sports. And minus the 1% when things get serious, it should be fun. So always keep that in mind. It's not that serious.